This is CBS.
I'm Dave, and I want to be your TV friend.
Tonight, from New York City.
Join me, Paul, and the Dave Letterman Dancers.
A conversation with David Letterman.
This is Times Square, the center of New York's theater district. I'm Harry Smith. Good evening. Just up the street from us is the new home of Late Show with David Letterman, the setting for the most interesting story in this fall's television season. Over the next 30 minutes, with his show set to premiere here on CBS, David Letterman will share with us his thoughts about himself, his comedy, and how a guy from the Midwest ends up on big-time TV here in the heart of New York City.
We're ready. We're going to roll.
1, 2, 3, 4. Roll to record.
Sorry.
What's your point?
Let's wait until the microphones are off and then really talk about it.
We're going to speak. Anytime, John.
Anytime, Harry.
This is great. This is cool.
Is it as cool as you thought it would be?
Yeah. Oh, it's great. I mean, isn't it the best? You get up in the morning and you get to be on TV. I mean, how can it not be cool? No, it's exciting.
Come on.
What, you don't think so?
Huh? Well, you've got this. You've got the band. You've got the audience. You have the biggest stars in America.
Well, that's what I'm
sitting there thinking. I'm going to have a heart attack because he's going to chew me up.
No, it's very exciting. There isn't in the 12 years we were on the air at NBC, there wasn't a night that I didn't get excited. I was always excited, not nervous. Some nights very nervous, some nights anxious, not like I am here today with you, of course.
Letterman has a way of putting you at ease and leading you unsuspectingly into punchline after punchline.
It's true.
That's what he did last January when it was announced that he would leave the NBC network for CBS.
We are truly delighted to welcome this great star to the CBS network.
January 14th, CBS Chairman Lawrence Tisch delivers the news. The rumors are true. David Letterman is in with an earlier time slot and a very lucrative deal.
And I want to thank them for their support. And also, I would like to thank them for their generosity because... This deal certainly would have put a smile on Jack Benny's face, even in the condition he's in now. He would have.
By July, Letterman was in Los Angeles, ready to meet the press for the first time since the January announcement.
I've been reluctant to meet the press.
Yeah.
Maybe it's snotty questions like that, pal. There he is. Get him.
Do you have any worries about moving from one network to another?
You know, I want the thing to work and work really well. But like I said earlier, maybe I'm just dumb, but I don't find myself kind of in a cloud of anxiety about this. Of course, I'm full of gin.
Letterman jokes about it, but ever since it became clear that he would leave NBC after more than a decade with that network, many have wondered just how he felt about it.
I was at BlackRock the night you announced... You are leaving NBC to come
BlackRock, the big CBS monolith.
It's a huge, important building. And I thought to myself, he's doing this for more than money.
I've never done anything for money. So it's nice, it's comforting, but it's never been a motivator in my life.
Why? Why come here?
I've been very lucky because there was a time about a year ago when NBC chose Jay Leno to host The Tonight Show. It seemed to me that I was superfluous. It just didn't seem to me to make any sense to have Jay Leno doing an hour of a talk show and then I would come on afterwards doing an hour of a talk show. And I really felt like, you know, maybe my time had come to step out of network television. And I wasn't happy about it. It just seemed to be the reality of the situation. So then through the ensuing months, when I found out that there was interest from CBS, I became cautiously optimistic. I didn't want to take a job anywhere else. I listened to a lot of people who had unbelievable offers. There's a couple of guys in business of syndication of television shows, and it's the King brothers. And these guys...
They're the richest people in the world.
They have all the money. And they came in and they said, yeah, we'll give you a show. Everybody gets Badlon shirts like we wear. We'll get you some gold watches. We'll get you chains. We'll get you your own theme park. How would you like that? Your own theme park. I thought, well, it's gotten silly.
Huge amounts of money. David Letterman leaves NBC, his home, this place that nurtured him and loved him and took
care
of him.
Wait a minute. Now, please, you're talking through your head here. There was not a great deal of love at NBC.
Are you hungry for the competition?
I'm hungry. Am I hungry? I'm describing myself now. I'm like a fighter. I'm eager to try and do a really good show. Because that, to me, is the, you know, your work is your ultimate satisfaction. Not the ultimate satisfaction, perhaps, but it certainly makes the day nicer if you think you're doing a good job. So I think we're all eager, all hungry, to use your word, to get on and do a nice show and to show a bigger audience what we think is a pretty good show. We hope. You know, we're going to try very hard.
Do you feel any pressure?
Actually, I'm getting hungry now.
Could I have a BLT? Don't you feel like a cookie? I just think it might have been easier to renovate Ed Sullivan than the theater itself.
This is the place David Letterman likes to joke about, the Ed Sullivan Theater on Broadway. Getting this place ready has been no easy task.
Ever since Ed Sullivan's last show back in the 70s, this theater had been falling into disrepair. So turning it into the new home of Late Show with David Letterman has required total renovation.
Last count, we actually saw more rats than seats at the theater. Saw Topo Gigio, the old mouse that in a stairwell eating an old grilled cheese sandwich. He looks horrible. The years have not been kind to Topo Gigio. The theater... It's unbelievable to watch. You go in there anytime, day or night, literally a crew of 200 people hammering, nailing, plastering, painting, and they're doing a great job. And I just, I so hope that it's ready.
Despite all the chaos, everybody knows the Ed Sullivan Theater is going to be ready by the time the show goes on the air. We're 10 floors above that now in the production offices, where they decide everything about how the show will go, including which celebrities to invite as guests.
Dana Carvey, I'm hoping to firm today, and I said we want to offer him the first Friday of the week.
Most of these people moved from NBC to CBS to stay with David Letterman. Holding the team together was an important reason for keeping the show in New York.
We had a chance. We could have gone to Los Angeles. We could have done this show out of the brand new CBS facility in Los Angeles, which you could walk into tomorrow and do a first-rate show. The beautiful things. And we kind of like the idea of staying in New York. It's a bit of a differentiation for us that we want to kind of protect. And also it would have required 40 or 50 people moving to Los Angeles and living somewhere near Barstow. I don't know. So we decided to stay here, and the writing staff is coming with us, the talent staff, the people who research and book talent and prepare the segments, all of those people are coming with us. I think we're about 75% of the people who were with us at NBC are coming with us to CBS.
Paul Schaefer?
Right.
Returns?
Yes, yes.
In his same capacity?
Oddly enough, he's running camera for us on the new show.
Okay.
So he'll be with us, but it's a little different job.
Musical director Paul Schaefer has been with Letterman from the start, creating a unique sound that helps set the show's mood.
Does the band change?
I'm adding to the band. I have the same four guys as the core guys. I'm adding two new guys.
Yeah.
Second guitar and a second synthesizer player. Because we've got some money to throw around now.
Thanks.
So the music will change a little, but not too much.
Paul Schaefer.
When we talked with the leaders of the production team, everyone said the same thing. Dave is Dave. Why mess with success?
When we're doing our jobs properly, we're serving him. We're booking the show to his liking. We're designing the show to his liking. And he's somebody who has a very definitive sense of what works and what doesn't work for him.
He is extremely funny. And in a sense, Dave doesn't really need writers. So what you have to guard against is falling into a situation where you start to write things like, well, give Dave spoons. He'll be funny with spoons. And the fact of the matter is he would be funny with spoons, but that's not exactly an idea. But let me just jot that down. Give Dave spoons.
The idea for the first show?
I think it is.
I just think
spoon bit.
That might not be so bad.
What about
Is it, for you, technically, is it a different, is there a different show to do at 11:30, 10:30 versus the old late night show?
There's a great fear that you're going to have a big barn of a place and you know, people will come in and say, oh, you couldn't get a laugh in a place like this, but you could be able to get laughs in this place. The ceiling's been lowered.
Someone said something about getting laughs?
Oh, I'm sorry, this is Rob, our head writer.
I didn't get the memo this is not the time to drop a bombshell.
Right, yeah.
Is there a sense, new network, new opportunity, we can show those guys, we're really the ones who ought to be on television at this time?
Yes. No, we wanted to be on at 11:30 for a long time.
Is there a sense among you about competition?
I mean, we're well aware of what they're doing, but does it worry us? Bring them on.
I want to get Topple.
Yeah, I want to kick his ass off.
All joking aside, the Letterman team has had to deal with some controversy these last few months. NBC said it owned the rights to Letterman's show.